In the book of Ephesians.
Vamos a mirar el libro de Efesios.
In the book of Ephesians, chapter 1 says,
en el libro de Efesios, capítulo 1 dice,
there is a glorious calling.
Que hay un llamado glorioso.
It is calling from God.
Es el llamado de Dios.
From your Father in heaven. You know, Jesus died for you.
¿Sabes? Jesús murió por ti.
Jesus died for you.
Jesús murió por ti.
For you to not die.
Para que tú no murieras.
For you to live.
Para que tú vivieras.
He died instead of you.
Él murió en vez de ti.
That is why you have this salvation.
Por eso es que tú tienes la salvación.
But this salvation is just the beginning.
Pero esta salvación es solo el comienzo.
Jesus did not just die for you.
Jesús no solamente murió por ti.
After the death,
luego de la muerte,
Jesus was resurrected.
Jesús resucitó.
And he went back to heaven.
Y él fue de vuelta al cielo.
And he promised that he's going to come back.
Y él prometió que él va a regresar.
But one more thing.
Pero una cosa más.
Jesus has called you.
Jesús te ha llamado.
Called you for the glorious calling. Salvation is just the beginning.
La salvación es solo el comienzo.
God wants to do something with you.
Dios quiere hacer algo contigo.
God wants to do something with you on the earth.
Dios quiere hacer algo contigo en la tierra.
God wants to walk with you.
Dios quiere caminar contigo.
God wants to manifest himself through your life.
Dios quiere manifestarse él mismo a través de tu vida.
Because he loves you.
Porque te ama.
Because when he sees the glorious calling,
y cuando él ve ese llamado glorioso,
he cannot see this alone.
Él no lo ve solo.
Because this is the heart of the Father.
Porque este es el corazón del Padre.
When he sees the glorious calling,
cuando él ve ese llamado glorioso,
he wants you to see the glorious calling. And he wants to share the glory to you. Because you are the child of God. Because you are the son of God. Because you are the daughter of God. You are not a slave. You are not a servant. You are the child of God. Because God loves you so much. The slave does not share the heart of the Father. The slave does not receive the inheritance. But the child receives the inheritance. But the child shares the glory. But the child shares the heart with the Father. And God did not call you to be the slave. God has called you to be the daughter. God has called you to be the son. And he wants to share the glory with you. And he wants to share the secrets with you. And he wants to hold your hand. The master does not hold the hand of a slave. Father holds the hand of the child. And God is your father. And he has called you to be the child. And he wants to hold your hand. And walk with you. Hallelujah. And I know that God has called me.
Yo sé que Dios me ha llamado.
I was born in an atheist family.
Yo nací en una familia atea.
Nobody knew about Christ in my family.
Nadie sabía de Cristo en mi familia.
Many people say, oh, Hyuk, you are born in a Christian family?
Mucha gente dice, oh, Hyuk, tú naciste en un hogar cristiano.
Is your parent pastor?
¿Tu papá son pastores?
No.
No.
My father sells some products.
Mi papá vende productos.
Oh, your father sells Bible.
Oh, tu papá conoce la Biblia.
No.
No.
My father sells foods.
Mi papá vende comidas.
I was born in an atheist family. I was the first one to believe in Christ. When I was 5 years old, I was an evangelist since I was 5. And I evangelized my parents. And because of me, my father and my mother came to Christ. I was just 5 years old. But God used me to evangelize my father. Evangelize my mother. And right now, God is using me for the harvest. Harvest of all the souls in all the nations. Thousands and thousands and thousands. And I am just an ordinary boy. I don't have a master's degree. I don't have any good position. I'm not a millionaire. I'm just an ordinary boy. If God can use me, why God cannot use you? I was a very poor boy who was sleeping with no bed, sleeping on the floor. And when it rains, the water will come into the room. Very poor. And one day I was in the middle school. I was kicked out from the class. I was a middle school student and sitting in my classroom. All my classmates were in the classroom. There were like 30 people. And suddenly one teacher knocked the door. Tuk, tuk, tuk. And he called my name. Chuck Park. Stand up.
Levántese.
You cannot stay here. Because your father didn't pay for your class. Come out. I was very shameful. Very, very shameful. I was born in a poor family. But now God is using me. No matter your circumstance, children, my friends, my brothers, my sisters, are you complaining about your situation? Are you complaining about your circumstance? When you look at your circumstance, you feel like that you don't have future. You feel like you cannot do anything. But no matter the circumstance, or your parents are divorced, or you don't have a father, or you don't have a mother, it doesn't matter. No matter the circumstance, no matter the situation, God is a miracle worker. And God is the way maker. And He does not look at your circumstance. And He does not look at your portfolio. He looks at your heart. If the center of your heart is focused to God, it is enough. 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 God wants to use you. And He has called you. Just one thing He needs is your heart. Is your heart. God will never do an interview with you asking where you are coming from. Where are you coming from? God is not interested about where you're coming from. God is interested in where you're going to.
Dios está interesado en el lugar en el que tú vas a ir.
And so no matter the situation,
así que, sin importar la circunstancia, la situación,
my situation was very bad.
Mi situación era muy mala.
Even my father went to a prison.
Incluso mi padre fue a prisión.
Because of the debt, he couldn't return the money to the bank.
Por una deuda, él no pudo retornarla al banco.
My father went bankrupt.
Mi papá estaba en bancarrota.
And he went to the jail.
Y él fue a la cárcel.
I was very poor boy.
Y un niño pobre.
And my mother was sleeping inside a container, something like container. It was not a house.
Mi mamá dormía como en algo parecido a un container. No era una casa.
And my father was in the jail.
Y mi papá estaba en la cárcel.
And I didn't have the money to take the bus.
Yo no tenía dinero para coger el bus.
But me,
pero yo,
I never complained to God.
Nunca me quejé con Dios.
And I was faithful to the Lord.
Yo fui fiel al Señor.
Because I love Him.
Yo lo amo.
You know David?
¿Sabe David?
People were trying to kill him.
La gente intentó matarlo.
While he was running away,
mientras él estaba corriendo,
he was still praising the Lord.
Él aún seguía alabando a Dios.
And God is looking for the David today.
Dios está buscando a los David hoy.
God is looking for the David.
Dios está buscando al David hoy.
Is there any David in this room?
Hay algún David aquí en este lugar.
Is there any David in this room?
Hay algún David en este lugar.
The circumstance has never called you.
No te ha llamado jamás.
The situation,
la situación,
has never called you.
Nunca te ha llamado.
God has called you.
Dios te ha llamado.
Your Father in heaven has called you.
Tu Padre en los cielos te ha llamado.
So it is not normal,
así que no es normal,
if you obey to the circumstance.
Si tú obedeces.
It is not normal,
no es normal
if you stop because of your circumstance.
Si tú te detienes de acuerdo a tu circunstancia.
It is not normal,
no es normal
if you sit down because of your circumstance.
Si tú te sientas por tu circunstancia.
Because the circumstance has never called you.
Porque la circunstancia no te ha llamado.
But God has called you.
Dios te ha llamado.
So if you don't change now,
no cambias ahora.
If you sit down in the circumstance now,
si tú te sientas allí en la circunstancia ahora,
10 years later,
10 años después,
you will find yourself sitting down in the circumstance again.
Te encontrarás nuevamente sentado en tu circunstancia.
But if you,
pero si tú,
respond to the calling today,
respondes al llamado hoy,
and run for the calling today,
corres al llamado hoy,
10 years later,
10 años después,
you will find yourself running in the calling.
Te encontrarás corriendo tras el llamado.
God is not calling you tomorrow.
Yo no te voy a llamar mañana.
God is not calling you next week.
No te voy a llamar la próxima semana.
God is not calling you next year.
No te estoy llamando para el próximo año.
Oh, let me settle my situation first.
Oh, déjame organizar mi situación primero.
My circumstance is so bad. Let me fix the circumstance first.
Déjame corregir esta circunstancia.
Oh, I don't have money.
Oh, no tengo dinero.
Let me earn money first.
Déjame hacer dinero primero.
So I can serve God comfortably later.
Así que puedo servir a Dios después.
No!
No!
God has not called you next year.
Dios no te ha llamado para el año que viene.
No tomorrow.
No para mañana.
No next week.
No la próxima semana.
God is calling you today. God is calling you today! Now!